take a look at an incremental analysis problem. In incremental analysis, we're choosing between two or three alternative courses of action, and we're going to look at what's changing when we make those choices. Sometimes it's called incremental analysis, sometimes it's called differential analysis, marginal analysis, or relevant cost approach. There are certain classic scenarios where incremental analysis is applied: the special order scenario, the decision about whether to discontinue a business segment, whether to sell a product now or process it further and sell it later, and the make or buy decision: do we make a component or do we buy a component for our product from the outside. Today we're going to look at the special order scenario. Special order in the context of incremental analysis has a very specific meaning. It means a customer comes to us, or a new customer comes to us, and says we want to place a big order, and because it's such a big order, we want a deal on the price. Let's take a look at Moonbeam Company. They're in the first 8 months of 2020, they're operating at 75% of plant capacity. So they have 25% of the plant capacity available to take on new orders. Their sales were $4,375,000 for 350,000 units. So before we go any further, let's figure out how much we sell our units for. We'll take dollars per unit. So somebody taught me a long time ago that the division bar, the fraction bar, or the vinculum, if you want to get technical, can be read as per. So let's put dollars per unit. 4,375,000 divided by 350,000 units means we usually sell our toasters for $12.50 each. Our cost of goods sold is $2,600,000, and by the way, of that, 70% is variable and 30% is fixed. That gives us gross profit of $1,775,000. Subtract our operating expenses of $840,000, and we learn that those are 80% variable and 20% fixed. And we end up with net income, I would prefer to call this operating income, of $935,000. So a customer, a new customer from Mexico, says, hey, we'd like to place a big order. We'd like to buy 15,000 toasters, but we only want to pay you $7.60. And if we do that, by the way, we're going to have to incur an extra $3,000 in shipping costs. Our fixed costs aren't going to change because, remember, fixed costs generally don't change in relation to new sales. And we have to figure out, is this the right thing for us to do? There are a few different ways you could set this thing up. Let's do it the simplest way possible. Let's have a column here for reject the order. For reject the order, that means we don't have any sales. We don't have any increase in cost of goods sold, any increase in operating expenses. We don't get none. And now let's see what would happen if we were to accept the order. Well, sales would go up by $114,000. That's the 15,000 toasters at $7.60 each. And what would happen to cost of goods sold? Well, if 70% of the cost of goods sold is variable, that means that 2.6 million times 70% is $1,820,000 that is variable. You divide that by the 350,000 toasters that they make, and you discover that that means the variable cost per unit is $5.20. So if we're going to sell these guys 15,000 units, that means the variable costs, and those are the only things that are going to change in this problem, go up by $5.20 per toaster. $5.20 by 15,000 is 78,000. Please remember that we're looking at what changes. That's what incremental analysis is all about. And so there's no change in the fixed cost, but that variable percent part of the cost of goods sold is going to go up by 78,000. What's going to happen to operating expenses? We know that total operating expenses are $840,000. It tells us that 80% of those are variable. So 0.8 times 840,000 means that $672,000 of this 840,000 is variable. We divide that by the 350,000 units we make. So that means the variable operating expenses per unit are $1.92. We're going to sell 15,000 units. 15,000 times that 192 is 28.8. But we also have to remember that there's an extra $3,000 of shipping costs for sending these things down to Mexico. So we'll take the 28,800 plus the 3,000 gives us 31,800 in variable operating expenses. We're almost done. 114,000 new sales minus $78,000 in new cost of goods sold minus $31,800 in new or incremental operating expenses gives us the answer of $4,200 in more operating income if we accept the order. The trick to these things, special order, is always, don't tell anybody, is always, does the sales price cover the variable expenses? Whether it's called cost of goods sold or operating expenses, look at the variable expenses, and if the sales price covers those, you're going to accept the order. Let's fill out this last column out here. This is supposed to be operating income increase in positive numbers or decrease in negative numbers. This revenue is an increase in operating income, so it's a positive number. This cost of goods sold is a decrease, so it's a negative number. Operating expenses is a decrease, it's a negative number. So you end up with your incremental analysis of 4,200, but we already knew that when we looked at these two columns. So don't get too disturbed by this third column. Those are the numbers for special order analysis. A couple qualitative things to keep in mind. If a regular customer comes in and wants to do business with us and we're too busy with this special order, we're going to lose out on the opportunity to serve our regular customers. So there's an opportunity cost to doing this special order. And most importantly, what will we say to our existing customers if they find out that we're selling toasters south of the border for $7.60 that we're charging them $12.50 for? So we've got to have a good explanation when our customers find out, and they will find out even if we don't have our brand name on them. All right, I hope that helps.